Ladies and gentlemen, we move on to fight number 8, brought to you by DPS Plastering. It is 3 rounds in the Salt Fight Series Lightweight Division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, all the way from the land of the rising sun, it is Yusuke Sato.
Here we go, an international, a bit of international flavor on this one. Yusuke Sato representing Japan here in Torquay.
23 years old, been doing karate for 17 years. My math is bad, but that's like 90% of his life.
I mean, my math's bad too, so I won't dispute that.
And judo for 8 months. So you're a little bit less on the grappling side of things, but we're going to see some awesome karate coming out of Yusuke Sato.
Here's a good one from Yusuke. I've got the pre-fight notes. He said, it's been 5 months since I started learning English. So well done, Yusuke. I'd like to ask for a simple interview. I already have an interview ready for when I win.
I love this. The confidence, the swagger with this guy. He's going to come out. It's going to be fun.
An incredible confidence level. Not easy to be in a foreign land. As you get your fight career started. Of course, plenty of martial arts experience on the karate side of things.
Now, his guide here is his, how he thinks he's going to win. All he's written is KO.
Simple, to the point, we like it.
Let's see if his notes are as precise as his striking.
Now, this is an interesting style matchup. We talked about kind of classic early days MMA stylistic matchups. This is a Muay Thai versus karate style match. Interesting to see that, how that plays out. I think we know an experienced karate striker in Yusuke. Does that sort of lead the opposition to grapple, to kind of try to exploit that potential lack of grappling experience?
And his opponent fighting out of the red corner. He is the fighting proud of the southwest from Port Ferry on the Great Ocean Road. Introducing Jaiven Callendar.
As we alluded to just before, Jaiven, a BJJ white belt, a little bit newer to the grappling art, identifies as a Muay Thai striker.
He has had some really strong showings on the AM Muay Thai circuit and really burst onto the scene with a head kick KO quite recently. So he's been driving 3.5 hour round trip up to Bones to do some sparring with the boys in preparation for this fight. But again, a real hometown favourite.
Shows some serious commitment for sure.
I complain about my 2 hour drive from Melbourne and this guy's doing almost double that. Good on you, Draven. Train better, be better. I love that motto on that jumper right there.
I like it.
Now, for the folks watching at home, we hope you've enjoyed the fight so far. This is fight number 8, brought to you by DPS Plastering. We are one fight away from our pro fight.
It's really hard to believe that we actually haven't seen a pro fight yet. The caliber of fights so far has just been exceptional. The girls just previously were no exception to that. It's really amazing.
Eleanor, are you getting the bug to maybe get in the cage?
Definitely not. I think watching those two girls go at it before, I was like, this is not for me.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is fight number 8 on the Salt Fight Series. 3 rounds in the lightweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, he has an undefeated record of 2 wins. He stands at 5'8" tall and weighed in at 70.1 kilograms. He is a karate fighter, fighting out of CMBT Training Center, all the way from the land of the rising sun. He is Yusuke Sato! And his opponent fighting out of the red corner. He has a record of 3 wins and 1 loss and also stands at 5'9" tall. He weighed in yesterday at 70.01 kilograms, and he is a Muay Thai fighter. Fighting out of Spartan in MMA by way of Port Ferry on the Great Ocean Road. Give it up for the fighting pride of the Southwest, Jaiven Callendar. Fighters to centering.
All right, gentlemen, we've been over the rules. Protect yourself at all times. Obey my commands at all times. Touch gloves. Step back. Let's do it.
Here we go. One of the most interesting stylistic clashes of the evening, you'd have to say.
Fighty ready.
It's going to be
ready.
A real old school battle of disciplines here, for sure.
Muay Thai versus karate. And you can see that wider karate stance. A big right hand to open up and a jumping push kick.
Just a
Yusuke is flurrying.
Yusuke has come out of the gates firing. He is going for it. He's going for an early win.
Huge start.
But he is getting lit up back. He is getting countered by Jaiven.
He predicted the KO. Things have slowed slightly here.
Crowd straight away getting behind this. The crowd is pumped. Crowd is excited.
Inside low kick takes away the base.
Callendar coming.
Swinging hand step up there.
The pressure is coming forward. Yusuke is coming forward. Slows it right down a little bit now.
If Yusuke can keep this up, he's going to be extremely difficult to deal with over the course of three rounds.
Yusuke looks big out there as well. Looks quite large.
Yep. He's filled out well since weigh-ins.
Callendar coming from high high. Surely used to a little bit more of a slow start than this.
Potentially, yep.
And he's precise with those hits.
Big round kick. Yusuke just kind of slides out of the way.
Close your fingers. Close your fingers, Blue.
Yusuke gets a warning from referee Jim Perdios about keeping the fingers open.
Does he understand the ref, though? Again, English.
Great question.
Very, very new to him.
The two clinch. You can see not a lot of interest in that clinch exchange from Yusuke. Probably if I was in the red corner, I'd be trying to press that a little bit more, not having a lot of success on the outside.
But it looks like he knows just enough to get himself out of bad situations like he just did there. Pulling out, getting back in
the
front.
Nice counter punches from Red. Jaiven needs to try to find establish some rhythm here and needs to kind of just keep Yusuke off him. Give Yusuke a reason not to just charge forward, deter that entry, get stung with a right hand.
These are hitting and they're hitting quite hard.
Yusuke is lighting Jaiven up here.
But Jaiven did say that he does want to slow it down. He doesn't want to pick his shots. He doesn't want to just rush in with punches. He's thinking more long-term.
There's some nice punches from Jaiven. Starting to put some leather on Yusuke here. A nice teep to the thigh. Catches the teep, then needs to answer it. Swings to the high kick, can't quite land it. Jaiven coming forward now. Controlling the center of the cage.
Jaiven did mention his forward pressure. And he did really feel comfortable encountering him. So we're seeing that now as the round progresses.
He's bleeding a little bit from the mouth, but he looks fine out there. He's composed himself. He's found his footing.
And you can see that blitzing karate style coming into play. Yusuke will step in between stances. That allows him to cover distance very quickly and land shots from unorthodox distance.
Real Leona Machida kind of vibe off Yusuke.
Certainly.
Stop! Stop.
Little knee up.
That was Inky sneaky little knee after the buzzer. He might not understand English, but he can hear the buzzer.
Big first round for Yusuke Sato.
Yeah, I believe the karate style almost threw Jaiven off at the start.
Definitely.
But then as the fight went on, it was Jaiven that started to really put things together a little bit more. He looked better at the end of the round than what he did from the start. Here we can see the replays. You can see Yusuke just flurrying his punches, his kicks, his knees. And Jaiven just defending himself really well, being able to pull himself out of bad situations. Here comes another one. Knees, punches, everything's coming out of him at once. Has this taken anything out of Yusuke?
I like the way Yusuke's chaining knees on the end of his punch offense. You notice in the one time that they kind of engaged in a clinch, Yusuke was not particularly interested in doing a whole lot outside of stalling. I would wonder if Jacob's kind of calls for a grab space offense.
Back up, back up, back up, back up. Back up, back up, back up, back up, back up.
Cool to see referee Jim Perdios officiating these amateur bouts. Of course, has refereed all the way up to the UFC.
Yeah,
Jaiven, pressing forward, showing some fakes, just trying to deter those blitzing flurries from Yusuke.
Yusuke's approaching this round a little bit slower than he did round one. I think in round one he wanted to surprise him with the flurry of attacks.
Yeah. And watch the way Yusuke lands that push kick to the bread basket, and he's happy to land in the other stance. That's why his volume can stay so high, is because he's adaptive. He lands in one stance, he continues to throw. He's happy to shift in between orthodox and southpaw.
He's also still looking really fresh. That he was so active in that first round, but he's still come out here with a ton of energy.
Let's see what Jaiven can do with this. Caught the push kick and sort of forced Yusuke to the floor.
Now, Yusuke isn't a grappler, as he said, so he might be in a whole new world right now. I'm sure he's done just enough to be able to manage these sort of positions, but we're going to have to see what Jaiven does from here. Is he going to look to just ground and pound? Is he going to look to pass to advance his position? And it is looking like he's looking to pass that guard. Yusuke not really doing too much with that top knee, with that knee shield there, getting pinned up against the cage and just copping those right hands. Got to watch those up kicks, though. Jaiven gets up, doesn't get up quite well. He did expose his back, taking him straight back down to the mat. You never want to turn your back on an opponent when you can.
Straight into full mount here.
I have to think, from what we've seen, this is a much more favourable position than on the feet for Jaiven.
Yeah, Jaiven on top in full mount. He's landing punches, he's hitting the body, hitting the head, and all Yusuke's really doing, he's trying to hold him down. He's trying to just, you know, use his power to get out of there. We're not really seeing him try to push, you know, back to a half guard, trying to push down on the hips or anything like that. He's just holding on.
Doesn't appear to have a ton of ideas here. We'd love to see Jaiven posture up and just start to rain down some ground and pound here.
Now, if Yusuke can start turning to his side a little bit, try to recover some sort of half guard here, keep bridging. He did one big power bridge. That was it. That's never going to be enough.
Yeah.
Here he's trying to pin the hand out. Now he's giving up his back. Both hooks are in. He can't fall off the top, though, so Jaiven has to be careful. Keep those hooks in. Yusuke looks like he's in trouble. He is feeding for that rear naked choke. Is it under the chin just yet? It's looking tight. We can't exactly see how close
that
it is. It is close.
Here.
He's let it go now, but Jaiven is just...
still under the chin with one arm, though.
More and more comfortable.
Yeah.
He's doing good defense. That 2-on-1, trying to get that arm to the other side of the head. We'll protect him from the choke.
Coming to the ladder state. Oh, and he's under the chin again.
Now he's got 10 seconds left. He's tucking his chin. He's turned his head. The choke is off.
Back to the mount. A couple of big shots to finish the round.
A lot of them are missing, though. A lot of those clock shots were missing. So, of course, that round wasn't the best for Yusuke, so we're going to have to see something change in round three. Jaiven just has to stick to his gameplay.
What's going to be interesting to me is to see how much that time on his back takes out of his ability to get back to the offense that we've seen that he likes in the early goings of round three. Is he going to be as quick on his feet?
Just can't risk getting taken down like we're seeing here. He got his foot caught. He had it caught before and he got out. This time around, Jaiven held onto that ankle and he lost balance, got him down to the ground. When it was on the ground, it just seems like Yusuke's a little bit out of his, it's a little bit above his pay grade when he's in the grappling exchange.
Really good as well to see that attitude change from Jaiven as he finished off that second round. Obviously, that first round would have been a real barrage for him to cope with, but really confident and really pumped as that buzzer went at the end of the second round to go back to the corner and have a bit of a break.
And I believe Jaiven knew this. He's a man who is thinking long term. He's a strategist. He's doing great. Great game plan put together.
And this third round as well, it's when that home crowd cheer
is certainly
going to come.
It really gets you through it. When you're feeling wrecked, when you're feeling tired and exhausted, the only thing that gets you through it is adrenaline. What? Imagine the adrenaline you feel from when you got this home field advantage and the people cheering your name.
Absolutely. The energy would be fantastic for them.
See a little bit less pop in the step of Yusuke in the beginning of the round. That could just be him being measured, trying to set up a counter. We probably could think Yusuke's thinking Jaiven's gonna press forward and look for the takedown, so maybe he plays a little bit more of a counter striking approach, try to catch him coming in.
And thank you DPS Plastering for bringing us Fight Night of the Night.
Big right hand. DPS plastering, great company run by Daniel Stroud. He's a professional Muay Thai fighter up next week on Rebellion. Actually employs and sponsors a couple of his teammates so they can get some paid time off work leading up to fights. Best boss ever. Yusuke doing some damage here, and there comes the takedown as we...
That level change was absolutely awesome. He dropped level, shot into the cage, took him down. That was fantastic.
Yusuke getting back to his feet here, but struggling to keep Jaiven off him.
That happened right in front of me, and we saw that knee strike...
South of the border.
South of the border. I've got to keep it PG.
Referee will call time. In the event of a green strike, the athlete has up until the duration of a round to recover should they choose to take it. So that's 3 minutes in this case, 5 minutes in a professional bout. Oftentimes, it's in the fighter's best interests not to use the entire time. You don't want to go too cold. You'd like to kind of stay in. Can also depend on sort of which way the momentum was going. But Jaiven quite keen to just get right back to it.
Hugh, have you been kicked in the beanbag before?
Many, many times. Really looking to attack that inside leg is Yusuke. Nice counter punches from Jaiven.
Now we're noticing Yusuke's not throwing as many high kicks anymore. I don't think he wants to get caught with that and get taken down again.
Blood really starting to come from Javen's nose now. Shoots in for the single leg.
Awesome level change. Grabs a single leg, but he's not able to finish. He's going to use the cage to rush him up against it.
And he gets it.
Does finish the double leg takedown again. Gets on top. He's in top side control now. Looking for a potential arm lock, maybe, if he can get that trapped. He's looking to separate the arms from the head so he'll have free rein on his head. This is a very bad position for Yusuke now. All he can do is move his head. Manages to free one arm out of there, but again, this isn't the best position for Yusuke right now. Now he's in trouble. Ref is looking very closely.
Yusuke doesn't quite seem to know where to go here. Referee watching super closely.
These hits are really hard. Clean.
He's also copying a bit of blood there from Javen's nose.
Yeah, Javen's nose is pouring now. Big shots landing, shifts into Mount.
Nice escape from Mount. There we go. Fine. Yusuke is copying it, and the referee is watching closely. The last 10 seconds.
Jaiven, I believe, thought about the guillotine for a second there, but with the 10-second clapper, just contend to punch. Yusuke is swinging. What a fight.
Jaiven finishing off wearing the crimson mask, bleeding from the nose. Yusuke doesn't look too banged up, but he did cop a lot of ground and pound at the end there.
Massive finish and incredible recovery from that first round from Jaiven. Yusuke was super awkward, giving him a lot of interesting looks and difficult strikes to deal with. Both sides look absolutely exhausted. Jaiven taking a seat on the cage. Yusuke doubled over.
It looked like Jaiven learned. He improved as a fighter in this match. He started off the fight. It was a bit awkward against a karate guy. And then just then, by the end of the fight, comes out looking like he's going to potentially win this one on the judges' scorecard.
And what grit as well to get through that first round and then just come out powering for the next two. He really just took it all in his stride.
Yeah, the mental toughness of Jaiven, that first round, a little bit rough. And then we saw him come back with a slightly different game plan round two and then ended up doing real well.
So many different local businesses have really gotten around this card. One in particular, one agency, the local real estate agent down here on the Surf Coast. They've put so much money and effort into making this a really good night for the fighters, good night for the crowd as well. So huge shout out to the agents down there, Sean O'Callaghan in particular. I've actually had a friend sell with him recently and he said, top notch. So.
Ladies and gentlemen, give a round of applause for these competitors. What an unbelievable fight. This fight has gone to the judges' scorecard and we have a unanimous points decision. Your winner, red corner, Jaiven Callendar.
Jaiven taking away the win. in a very, very impressive fight. Again, round one was a little bit rough for him. Round two and three, he showed it well.
A well-earned win. Sure to look like one-way traffic for Yusuke in the early goings of round one, but it's a mature showing for Jaiven, adjusted well, picked his shots, and once he got that fight where he needed